Recording now. Oh no, I can. Yeah, I can pick. Oh yeah, I've got Super Dante, don't I? I do like the DMC1 costume with no coat. I think that looks pretty cool. Let's go with that one. But yeah, we'll do hard because the enemies you can't really. Like, you're gonna have to. Like, jump cancelling is gonna be. Actually. I don't know. It might actually be fine. I don't know. Like. We'll see. We'll see how this goes. We'll go Swordmaster. I did want to, like. Figure out the turbo here as well. Be handy for Cerberus. Okay, they're still dying pretty quick. No stinger. I can't remember if it was. I don't think so, but if not, I really like Stinger should just be like a default thing going forward because the game feels so weird without it. Hard to, like, I mean, you can taunt, it's just, like, the button's just kind of awkward to get through. Yeah, the button, like, the taunt is just awkward to do. Okay, that felt okay. Taunt is a bit weird. Oh, man, that was just too slow. An S rank is pretty nice on mission 1, so. Although I think I can get Stinger level 1. Yes. And 2 is. Okay, we should get 2 on this one. No. Hopefully. I might mess with the buttons in a minute, I don't know. Oh, it feels so good to have Stinger back. I haven't quite got the angle for that jump cancel yet. No air hike either. Oh, I can't, I can't like change my locked on enemy. Helm splitter cancels are pretty tricky at the best of times, so. There we go. It might be better with like moving. Maybe moving like. Think about it. I don't use guns that often. It might be better using like this for aim. And then like jump cancelling would be like. I don't know. We'll see. We still managed an S rank, only just. What was that? I don't know if that's enough for. Enough stinger level 2. Wrong one. I don't know. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, you can't not have stinger level 2, really. Even though for this mission, it's not really that. Yeah, not exactly necessary. Hey, what's up, Tofu? I literally just beat it, like, just today. I just beat that just now, playing before this stream. Really, really enjoyed it. I'm definitely gonna, like, finish off a couple of things. I do want to get all the power seals, just to see what you get. And I unlock New Game Plus, but I don't want to, you know, I do want to actually, like, you know, finish some other games. But, yeah, I really, really enjoyed it. A much longer game than I was expecting. I think my total playtime on my first run, I think, was like 12 hours. Which is pretty crazy. Oh, hang on. Oh, that's an awkward... That's a very awkward button press. I will be using the shotgun more, though. But yeah, I really, really fantastic game. I can't really say enough good about it. And apparently there's going to be a sequel. If the ending's anything to go by. Back. I do, like, air hike is another one, like. Like, DMC without double jump feels kind of weird. I didn't see that shit coming. I did play NG on stick, yeah. I did. It's really fun. And NG04 feels great, really, because there's no, like, actual, like, lateral camera control in NG04. So, you know, you don't miss out on that, whereas normally, like, you would have camera control, which is actually a pretty big deal. So, but no, it feels great on the stick. Okay, now then, let me try and... Okay, so I want... Turbo. Nice. There we go, that works. Because, I just can't be... I don't want to just... Because I'm just going to shoot Cerberus, so... I don't care. Can you break them? No. It's easier. Well, safer, I guess. This feels right. Weapon switching feels, like, kind of odd, though. Oh, yeah, I can't change target, can I? That's a problem. There's no L... No, there's no L3. I'm kind of like... Okay, right, there we go. Yeah, there we go. I want that. There we go. Nice. Change your head. Fuck. Funny how on, like, Dante Must Die, like, it's just that recovers, like, fucking instantly. Okay, get that one now. Change head. God damn it. That's almost what I needed. How is their style to go? Probably should have gone with Trickster for this one, actually, because, yeah, like, Trickster's dash is really good at getting around that. Okay, there we go, that's all his head's done. No. Oh, man. Yeah, like... I didn't think of that. Like, not being able to change target is actually a pretty big pain in the ass. you change target with L3, and I, you know, you don't have an L3 on... I don't have L3. That's... Then again, like, it's not... It's only going to be a huge pain for this, like, specific boss. Motherfucker. Hey, what's up, TGD? I am doing well, thanks. I hope you're doing well, too. You're having a good Saturday. I mean, I can just shoot him from here, so... Oh, no double jump. Gotta remember that. Turbo makes this, you know, a bit less irritating. And there we go. Nice. Back. Oh, nice, nice. Yeah, I can say it must be pretty early over there. I really had half a mind to try some NG runs today, I'm not gonna lie. But after that stream yesterday, I thought, nah, fuck that. Because in your head, you think, oh yeah, I'll try some runs, it'll be fun. And then, you know, you think, oh no, like, what if the game just decides to fuck you over for like 2 hours straight? Yeah. Nah. No, thank you. There we go. Still recovering from... Yeah, exactly, yeah. Hey, what's up, Maze? Yeah. So, and I think that's what's really... I mean, it's the same on any difficulty, I suppose, but... It's just... Master Ninja can really quickly just completely... You know, just like, right, well, this run's dead. You know, and that can happen so easily. There's so many things that can do that. But hey, what's up, Maze? I finished the Messenger before this stream. And man, just what a fantastic game. Like, there we go. Like, truly, truly fantastic game. And apparently there's another one. They're going to make another one. And that's kind of a weird blessing in disguise of being a bit late to the party, I guess, is that... you know, because I was, you know, I didn't play it when... It originally released. If there is a sequel, it's probably a bit closer for me. Now then. Yeah, it doesn't really work with that, does it? Again, no way to change target. Fuck, that's super awkward. These are the only enemy. I feel like these guys, I can't remember what they're called. Is it Enigmas? I really can't remember, but... I feel like these are like the only genuine, like, blight on this game. These enemies are just... dog shit. And, like, they're like, the one enemy that make, like, DMD, like, pretty hard to, like, legitimately recommend. Oh, yeah. The style, like, the... Not style switch, sorry. The weapon switch buttons being, like, so far behind me, like, that felt super weird. I wish taunt was a better button than that. Fuck. I mean, like, even not like that's hard, and that was like half my life bar. Like. Yeah, I can't remember what they're called. YouTube is being weird. It won't let you remove a video. Oh, what am I? Oh, Itagaki made a Twitter. Oh, okay. So I told people to tag him to watch the speed run or the single segment no damage run. It'd be cool if he did. the best way to... I mean, I actually don't... That wouldn't surprise me with Itagaki, like, if he did. I feel like he'd just be a bit... I honestly feel like he'd just be a twat about it. He'd be like, oh, well, I did that. It's like, no, you didn't. Like, no, you didn't. Don't lie. Yeah, Navan's great for them, but this is a fresh game. Which I might regret, because it's like, fresh game on this is like... Oh, they are called Enigmas. What's up, Zero? Yeah, I thought so. I thought they were called Enigmas. Like, those guys on Dante Must Die are just... Like, oh my god. Like, they can kill you in one shot. It's not fun. Yeah, so... Oh yeah, I totally forgot. I have, what's it called now? I don't know. I have Cerberus. Yeah, that feels super weird. The one thing that, like, puts me off using Cerberus in this game, and I wish they had it, I don't know if, like, maybe modders have done it, but if Cerberus had Air Hike, I feel like I'd use it way more. Yeah, like, hitting the weapon swap buttons is, like, super weird. Oh, man, that's, like, super awkward. I don't know if there's really a better way to, like, do that configuration, like... Because I could... Like, I'm trying to think, like, what do I, like, A, like, A and B I'm going to use all the time. I don't really, like, shooting, you don't use as much. So, I don't know, maybe, like, move that off there. So. Yeah, I'm not going to bother going for the blue orbs. I don't need them. Once you get, I mean, I feel like, yeah, pretty much, it's once you get Beowulf, pretty much, you're good to go. I do want the shotgun for this, though. Actually, no, I don't. Oh, that's just super, super weird. Like, I mean, that's not too, but the only thing with that is I have to take my finger off of lock on. I don't like that. Because then I'm gonna, like, lose whatever I'm locked on to. Oh yeah, I forgot. I have turbo on that. Man, like, using my thumb to hit, like, style, like, weapon switch, that's kind of madness is that. Okay, there we go. Right, Gigapede. Oh, this guy can be annoying. We'll try for the, it's only YOLO for me, because I'm, like, mad rusty, but... Oh my god, he only did one fireball? That pissed. I actually got that as well, you son of a bitch. Oh yeah, now you fucking do them all. Ah, what a bitch. You know, I just thought there's a way to skip this boss, isn't there? I just remembered. There is a way to actually, like, not bother with this guy. Because he's just... I mean, but he's not terrible, I guess. It's just... He's one of those bosses that just, on a new game, he's just... He's such a drag. Like, when you have, like, you know, like, Beowulf and that, and, like, Nivan and Swordmaster upgraded, he's not bad. But... When you don't, he's kind of a pain. Okay, so he should do it now, then. Every time. Every time, like, I try and be ready for, like, the purple orbs, like, he doesn't do it. Ah, fucking hell. Right, so... Okay, projectiles are, like, further away. That's a pretty easy way to remember that. What's the, like, at rifle chord in this game? Spiral's really good on this guy, too. Of course, now you do it. The camera is, like, kind of annoying. Hey, what's up, Matt? Yeah, it's one of those things where, like on very hard and DMD, I feel like he's way more consistent. Because, like, he pretty much always does purple orbs, like, when you stand on his head. And then you can just, like, reflect them back at him. I'll just wait for him. Come on. Yeah, that's actually pretty decent damage. Chunk of damage. Alright. Depending on what he does here, we could kill him, but... Is he gonna do it? No, of course not. Like, one lot of orbs there would have been dead, pretty much. Oh my god, he's like, look at that, man. He's on like fucking magic pixel. There we go. God, that is a boring boss. I remember on a fresh DMD run, like, god, that's like maybe the worst fight in the game. I forgot we've got Jester after this, haven't we? And you, the first one, you can't skip. Yeah, no L... Yeah, there's no L3 on this. Some sticks do have an L3. My Hori's got an L3, actually, now that I think about it. But I don't have that here. Agni and Rudra. Okay, we'll go... Revolver level 2. Save for... Won't need to get much Devil Trigger. No fucking I cannot believe I didn't think of that. Like, how annoying that would be. Like, not being able to change my target. This room on DMD. Well, like one, like just one hit from off screen is like a quarter of your life bar. Alright, there we go. Where'd he go? Just thought. We got turbo. There we go. We'll go shot E4. Oh no, we want this. Oh, no DT, this guy's gonna be... This, to be fair, I mean, this isn't a terrible boss, but... Not exactly a great one, either. Actually, probably easier to like melee switch that way. I mean, it is easier, but it's still kind of a pain in the ass. God, the frame rate like fucking dies on that attack. I think if you, if you hit the green ones, they drop a green orb, I think. I have to admit, like, aside from, like, the first time, like, this is a boss fight that, like, I pretty much always skip, because I've never been a big fan of it. There we go. Right, that's the only Jestify out of the way. How are we doing for money? Okay, we're doing pretty good. We got 20 grand. Each air hike is 20k. And I think I might just get... Beowulf and Rebellion's air hike. I think you can actually just drop down there, but... First run, for the longest time, I had no idea that thing was there. I was, like, pissing around for ages trying to fall into that, like, without air hike. We've got more... Yeah, we've got more enigmas coming up, don't we? Yeah, that's another thing, actually, now that I think about it, on like, the Scratch DMD run, the amount of things that just one-shot you on your default health bar is fucking insane. That looks really cool, but it's never intentional. Like, slashing the Enigma arrows away. Yeah, we just go back this way now. Oh, I think it's quicker to actually go outside. I've got the lift, I want the shotgun for that. Oh no. No, what am I doing? This way. The hedge trimmer guy is gone, but he's been replaced by a leaf blower guy. Lovely. I don't know if you guys can hear that. You might be able to. Yeah, that no like lock on toggle is gonna be a pain here. Get off my lift. Okay. Nice. Alright, level 2 style, that's good. Yeah. That's fair. No orbs up here, aren't there? I remember finding out where a lot of those like orb caches were just from watching Pokey's videos way back in the day. Swordmaster's not really going to be that much use here, but I don't really feel like doing like roll Royal Guards on this, so. Whoops. Oh shit. Oh crap, how'd you get to your items? Oh, isn't items on the D-pad? Oh no. Start. Okay. fuck was that? One second. I think leaf blower guy just knocked a bin over. Okay, there we go. Right. There we go. Love how they just like indiscriminately just wallop each other whenever you do that as well. Okay, that didn't go like that. Should have hit me, but. Oh, shit. No double jump. Alright. Maybe I should have gone Royal Guard. Not him. That was close. Yeah, I love Agni and Rudra. They're a great boss fight. I usually really prefer Royal Guard for them, but. And I'm a bit rusty on the whole, like. Because if I remember rightly, I think with Air Hike, you can just do. You can just do, like, Helm Splitter. You'll get a Ricochet. Like Air Hike, Helm Splitter. Like, you can. Like, basically, as soon as they attack you once, if you time it properly, you can disarm them. Like. Instantly, pretty much. It's just, it's timing on that's a bit rusty. Right, I do want Trickster here. Amazing how much of the game you think about it, in DMC1. You get Devil Trigger in the second mission. You have to wait pretty long to get it in this game. Like the eighth mission is when you have it. Like, it's it's pretty long. Yeah, Royal Guard's awesome. I love Royal. Like, it took me a while to, like, learn to love it, though. Fun fact, the solution to this puzzle is the same as the COG as, like, the underground puzzle in the remake. It's 4-2-3-1. Which one is the fighting one? Is it this one? No, it's not. Alright. I also like how this is harder on, like, as you go up in difficulty. Like, Royal Guarding through this is pretty sick. But we'll take the easier way out here. He says as he fucks it up. There's no boss on this mission, is there? It's like one of the few that there isn't a boss for. That isn't in. I don't know if it annoys anyone else. In DMC4, in the opening cutscene, like after the first mission, Nero does that, like, you know, where you jump on them and slide around. and you can't, but it's not actually a move in the game, and that always bugged me. Because with the exceed mechanic, that could have been pretty sick, and yet, like, he does it in a cutscene, and yet you can't actually do it in the game. Oh, I forgot about that. That's annoying. Because I might try 4 after this. It's pretty fun. Hey, what's up, brother Ties? I was cutting grass. Fair enough. Probably do one Agni and Rudra until, like, because Beowulf's, like, pretty far, isn't it? Beowulf is mission 11. Well, mission 12. You get it at the end of mission 11. Nice. Yeah, finish the messenger. I'm going to try a bit of Katana Zero later, I think. Well, I'll try a bit more of it. Well, I'm really enjoying that as well. Strong Hotline Miami vibes, which is good. Yeah, Agni and Rudra is good for Virgil as well. What do I want for Agni and Rudra? Oops. No. I want High Time. That's pretty expensive. I'm not going to get that yet. So. Hey, did you see, Matt? Dead Space got a release date. January 27th, next year. Get excited. I should be booking the day off for that. I want to stream that, because I've been thinking about what I'm going to do at the end of this year. And I, on the one hand, I want to stream it. But on the other... I might be finally getting the new TV plunge out the way at the end of the year, and I would very much like to play that on the big TV. That'd be nice. Okay, let's practice some jump cancels here. Not bad. There we go. But yeah, I'm gonna get back to Resident Evil probably tomorrow. I'm probably gonna, like, I don't think I'll be live tomorrow because I really need to, like, catch up on some videos tomorrow. This is one of the few times in my feed that I don't have anything in the queue. Like, everything is, like, live that I have right now. On the YouTubes. Well, not quite everything, but everything that's, like, ready to go. Now then, Virgil does not have Devil Trigger in this first fight, thankfully. I believe that's a holy water. Yep, which I want. Yeah, I mean, I know Dead Space 1, like, very well. And especially after playing it through, like, quite a few times recently. Get wrecked. Fucking bot. Is there a cash here? There's probably some of those I've forgot, but I've remembered a pretty decent amount. Because, like, the 2 air hikes I need is 40 grand. Like, that's a lot. I should probably buy Air Hike. It's quite a few missions before Beowulf, so. Is this a Devil Star? I don't know. I like the look of the stars in this game. I think they look really cool. Right, we definitely want Agni and Ruja here. Yeah, I think in... Correct me if I'm wrong, but I know in 4, Air Hike's just like a universal ability. And I think, like, probably should have been the case here. Because you have Air Hike on 3 weapons in this game. You know, with how slow that is, it's probably better to just, like, hit him. Yeah. Like, jump cancels are. It's going to be interesting to see how, like, Virgil jump cancels feel. That's just, like, not in my muscle memory at all. I just thought that was gonna hit me. Thought there's an orb thing in here, right? I think. Yeah, alright. Yeah, let me. Oh, yeah, no, Air Hike. God damn it. I swear there's an orb cache on one of these pillars. You know what? Never mind. Yeah, I'll try 4 after this, I think. Because I have 4 on PC. So, I mean, well, I have 4 on PS3 as well, but I'll probably just play on PC. Actually, yeah, I didn't think of that. Although, I won't have the annoying, like, split audio problem when I play on PC. There is that to consider. And when Al's sorted, moving-wise, we're going to start a new series, which I'm pretty excited about, because it's one that it's not NG-related, but it's kind of in, like, the same kind of style, so it'll be cool to see how people dig, like, if people dig that. Okay, this guy can fuck off. Go away. I can do that, but then I can't. Like, there's no way to do that with keeping my finger on the stick. It's not too bad, it's just like, I really have to think about doing that, you know what I mean? Getting better. Though. I'm really lucky I didn't get hit though. Maximum mashing. No, because that game doesn't exist. It's a weird phenomena that. It's like flat earth, you know? People seem convinced that, you know, like, there was a Devil May Cry 2. I don't know where people get this idea from. I really don't. But it's just not true. And Capcom, like, go along with it as well, which is weird. Like, because on the HD collection, there's Devil May Cry 2, but when you select it, it just says, no, this game doesn't exist. This is a joke. And it just puts you back to the main menu. Fun fact. Right then. I need one button for DMC2. I mean, yeah, that's true. Okay, we're getting better. It's basically just like 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. You know what it feels similar to actually? Is like a double roll button, like a roll command from like Tekken or something. Like for example, when you do like one jump cancel, you then like roll but keep the button pressed. It's kind of a similar feel to that. But it's just, like, I still have to actually think about, oh yeah, it's like 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. And the reason it's so hard is because, like, I have to keep this down and, like, using my other fingers with that is just super awkward. Can't skip this cutscene for some reason. No, don't play DMC2, it's terrible. Just play 1, 3, and 4. That's all you need. I mean, to be fair, 5's good, it's just... I feel like if you play 1, 3, and 4, then, you know, like, 5 might feel a bit stale. 5's not a bad game, it's just... Well, V sucks. There we go. I just feel like, in a way, like, 5, it feels like, in the weirdest way, they tried to do too much, but not enough. Wouldn't mind playing Virgil in that though. Hey, what's up, Espana? Nice stick. It is. Power drill, guys. He keeps going. I just thought, actually, I won't. Too many hits. This may be fun. There we go. That's the combo. I love how Virgil, like, has Royal Guard. We hit him so much, We turned off his haircut. That actually feels pretty good for like weapon swaps. Motherfucker. Got him. He really does suck. Yeah, he does, yeah. Like, I don't know what they were thinking with him, honestly. Like, he's... And he's one of the few examples of, like, everyone seems to really hate, like, playing as him. No one's like, yeah, V is awesome, man. Like, he's my favorite character in DMC5. I've never heard anyone say that. Oh, I actually wanted to watch that because that cutscene is so fucking cool. Never mind. Right. You know what? No. We got one more. Man, holy waters are expensive in this game. Jesus. I forgot about that. 10 grand. Maybe they realized that making them like dirt cheap like they did in the first game was not a good idea. Because like holy waters in 1 are so cheap. And yet, like even on like DMD, like they're pretty decent. Like they're pretty powerful. They're a really weird item in 1 though. Because I've been watching the DMC1 speedruns quite a bit lately. Because I really am thinking of giving that a go. And like 1 holy water... like will take off like a like 3/4 of certain bosses' health bars. It's fucking crazy how powerful they are. And I think even in this game, like they were toned down a little bit. Hey, what's up, Black Dragon? Welcome. How you doing? How's your weekend? How are you doing this fine Saturday? It's a nice day so far. You know what's going to feel really weird on DMC4 is doing exceeds. Because it's... By default, it will be like... Actually, that's not... You know what? Yep, yeah. Oh, okay, that feels a lot more comfortable. I've been trying to hit it, like, with my thumb. Like, just go into, like, claw grip. Feels a lot better. Alright. Still a bit awkward, but it feels a lot better than how I was doing it before. I think that's the only part where you actually have to jump. Yeah, that feels so much better. Wait, have I not? Yeah, I want Ebony and Ivory. Can do the lazy man's jump cancel then. We can just go. Yeah. There we go. Hang on, can I just... Oh, that's cheap as fuck. Because I've got turbo on. I can just do that and like get perfect like Ebony and Ivory Aircross cancels. Oh, that's cheap. That's cheap. Oh, I do love the million stab combos. If like arcade stick buttons are like, you know, soothing to you, I guess this is probably quite nice to hear. So tried Flaming Hot Mountain Dew. Flaming Hot Mountain Dew. What? Please explain. As in like a chili? Is that what it sounds like? Mountain Dew, but it's... chili flavored? I can't believe I didn't think of that earlier. That's so much easier. Mountain Dew Flaming Hot. Yeah, like, that sounds... that doesn't sound good, to be honest. But, you know, you never know. Knock it, do tried it, as they say. But I can't imagine that is particularly pleasant. Oh, that's cheap. I don't think that's actually as good as doing it manually, because I swear if you time it properly, like... I swear you can get four. Like, you can get air cross four times on, like, a regular jump if you're quick enough on your cancels. I swear that's possible. It's like the Cheetos Flaming Hot, but a drink. Why? Why would that sound horrible? I mean, you never know. It could be good, but it doesn't sound great. I jump right into that. Need to start trying to rack up some cash. We're getting close to, mission 12 here. That cannot be profitable as a product line. I mean, I guess people are going to try the new thing. Is it actually, like, is it good? Would you have it, you know? Would you be like, yeah, I could go for some of that. Alright, so I gotta remember, I do have Devil Trigger now. So. I mean, to be fair, it's one of those things where if I saw it, I would try, like, I'd try it just for funsies. There we go. Oh. No air hike. I love it when he does that, because, like, it's just free damage. Ooh, I got it. I really do miss air hike. I'm gonna have to get air hike after this, like... Shit, I'm too close. Because, like, you can get above where, like, you won't land in that with air hike. Oh yeah, I forgot this guy like takes my shit, doesn't he? Legit forgot what that attack does. Dante. He's been at Ryu's moonshine. He's not targeting the right guy. There we go. We should be able to kill him on this, I think. There we go. Nice. So from DMC and onwards, there are 20 missions. Yeah, I believe so, yeah. There's 20 in 20 and 3, 20 and 4. I want to say there's 20 in 5, but don't hold me to that, because I haven't played through 5 in quite a while. Really? That was an S rank? That felt like a shit run of that mission. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you play Dante and Lucia. What's up, Roll? Lucia's actually quite fun in that game. Right, we need Air Hike. There we go. We need it. Okay, Nevan time. Aircross councils are going to be really tricky now. What about DMC team? It's just a shit game. I mean, if you want to get technical, like, the enemy design is crap. The moves you have available are boring. Guns are, like, the game feels, like, designed more around guns than melee. And it's just, yeah, like, the bosses fucking suck, like, everything you would want to be good in an action. You know what? Because I can't use, I can't really abuse Devil Trigger Explosion because of this control. Like, this might be the first time since, like, my initial playthrough where I don't just use Devil Trigger for Devil Trigger Explosion. Agnian Rouge is really good on spiders. Yeah, what else is there about it? The amulet system is, like, a good idea, but it's never really put to any good use. You have different weapons, like, you have different swords and shit, but, like, they don't really do anything differently. It's just... Oh, man. And coming from, like, DMC... Like, the fact that DMC 1 is such a more, like... complex and, like, well-made game is fucking insane. Like, how DMC 2 happened, I would love to know. Because, I mean, they had a pretty amazing blueprint to go from with 1, and it's like, what the fuck happened? Like, just what happened, man? Yeah, DMC, yeah. And it's weird, because when I first played it, like, I played it a lot, too. I try, like, it was the same with NG3, funnily enough. Like, I really tried to like that game. I played through it through DMD, I played through it again, played Bloody Palace. And it's just... Oh, no. good neat. It's good, as you were saying. I forgot. Got my zoning tools now. That's close. Great stuff, Dante. You've definitely been at Ryu's moonshine. That was something Ryu would do right there. You get so much Devil Trigger for taunting. It's crazy.
Okay, I feel like... I can like all the DMCs except DMC from Ninja Theory.
I liked that one. I didn't mind it. It's definitely not as it's not as good, you know, as the ones that came before it. But I wasn't really expecting it to be. And I know that's like, that sounds like kind of a backhanded comment, but like, it's just, you know. To expect it to be as good as DMC3, like, there's not many action games I would put in the same, like, you know, league as DMC3. Like, off the top of my head. Like, NGB, Shadow of Rome, DMC1. Yeah, there's not many. I feel like DMC3, along with those other games, is like very much in a league of their own when it comes to action games. In some ways, I do like there are aspects of 4 that I prefer to 3. The biggest thing with 3, I think, is just and I feel like every DMC is guilty of this. Is that, like, your subsequent runs are just, can be quite boring. Like, this run right here is, like, it's okay, but I miss having all my moves, you know? You can tell that the game is designed around having, like, your completely full arsenal, so when you don't have it, it's a bit of a drag. Yeah, I love Bayonetta. Bayonetta's awesome. I mean, I would probably put Bayonetta in the same category. It's just I don't have, like, as much experience in Bayonetta as I do, like, NG, DMC, like, Shadow of Rome and all that. But, like, I don't doubt that if I really, like, dug into Bayonetta, I would, you know, I would put it in the same tier, for sure. All right, then. I can't speak for Bayonetta 2, but, like, Bayonetta 1 is pretty sick. Pretty sick game, that is. Ooh, you little bitch. Come back here. Uh-oh. I was trying to taunt. Okay, so we get Nevan now, which is... Although, I probably won't use Nevan all that much on the first playthrough. Hey, what's up, Archon? How are we doing today? Oh my god, I forgot the thing. What dumbass. Forgot the item that you need. Hang on, isn't there a... There's something down here, isn't there? Ah, yes. Sorry, but man, it's getting warm, you know. I can feel it. I've got my door open and, like, we've got ventilation and everything, but I can feel it getting quite warm. Is it 4:30? Yeah, I got my missions mixed up. It's this way. Here we are, yeah. It's 12:25 PM. I'm having breakfast and I enjoy the stream. Nice. Wanna stay up? I mean, if your sleep pattern's already messed up, you know, you might as well be chilling. I really don't think they should be able to shoot when they have Rebellion impaled in them. That kind of bugs me. can lock him down with Spiral, but... Yeah, people seem to love the DM... Like, a lot of people were pretty surprised. Like, that DMC1 run. Like, a lot of people were surprised. Like, oh, I didn't know you played DMC. It's like, bruh. Like, you know, I grew up playing DMC. That's still one of my favorite things to do in like three. You just end a combo in a stun in Devil Trigger, and then you just like you come out of Devil Trigger and taunt, and then like you basically just get like almost two orbs back. Yes, Dante, that's the one I wanted you to hear. Motherfucker. I think my friend told me about that in DMC 1, that taunting gives you Devil Trigger. I was like, dude, really? Because, like, for a while, we really wondered what the point of taunting was. Like, what does this do? Like, this is dumb. And he told me, I was like, yo, dude! I'm like, if you taunt, you get Devil Trigger. I'm like, dude, I'm like, really? Like, and a lot of it, too. Like, that'd be a, I don't know what you would use it for in NG, but oh man, like imagine if in like NG you could taunt and you got like it gave you a points bonus, like you got like more points if you taunted. That would be sick. Yeah, he just says, yeah, he's like, come on, doesn't he? He just says like, he's like, bring it. I do really like how, I don't know, like, I feel like Dante, it, like, in, like, a lovable way, but he's kind of lame in this game, like, but he, like, thinks he's cool, do you know what I mean? Like, he thinks he's super cool, and I feel like the game does kind of, you know, like, wink at you and be like, you know, like, this guy thinks he's cool, but we know he's kind of a knob. You know, I do like that about this one. Ione should absolutely have a toin. Well, it just, it'd have to function, I mean, it'd be the same way as, like, UT, I guess. Like, if you taunted, like, you could get, I mean, taunting in Bayonetta's cool as well, because, like, it pisses the enemies off, but you get, like, more points that way. Okay, I can't do that. I'm trying to hold, like, Devil Trigger Explosion here. No, that's not gonna work. No. I know there's somewhere you can stand where that won't hit you, but I can't remember where it is. Cheap bitch. Oh, you just get one of them on hard, okay. I do miss Killer Bee Councils on this boss. I just thought I can taunt when she's doing that. Are we gonna? Yeah. Trying to give me the mix. That's good for Killer Bee Councils, but Air Cross is kind of tricky when she's on the floor. I feel like it's easier to do Air Cross when she's stood up. I know there is a way to stun her on that. I know, because like Devil Trigger Explosion does it. That's such a Capcom trait, like the bosses' attacks like lasting longer the lower their health gets. Cool, now we have Nevan. That's another one where I think a lot of people, especially early on, were like, oh, this weapon sucks. Like, and then you realize like just how good Nevan is. You're like, oh damn. Like, this weapon does not suck. This weapon is very, very good. So that wasn't the best Nevan fight. Yeah, it took a while. Not bad, though. Not bad. We're almost halfway through, so yeah, mission. Yeah, we'll do this mission, and then I'm gonna get some food. Actually, I'm quite hungry. I don't remember. Is this mission? Yeah, we'll wait. Because it's not long now till we get Beowulf. Or Beowulf, depending on how you want to say it. That's one of those words, isn't it, right? Like, there's so many different ways you hear people pronounce it. Like, there's Beowulf, Beowulf, Beowulf. Like, is there a ruling on what is the, you know, proper way to say it? Is it? I don't know. Is it green? It's my favorite weapon. I just don't. I don't know how to use it. I just like it because it's a freaking Psy-Guitar hybrid. There is quite a bit of nuance to Nevan, to be honest. Like it does. Like, if you really know like how it works in terms of like its shield and that, like, it really does a lot. It's pretty broken, actually. It's an amazing weapon. Like, the bats will shield you from projectiles. Like, you can stack them and stun enemies. The Swordmaster like air like slice is incredibly powerful. Like, that and Beowulf's like double punch is super good. Like, if there's an enemy where you can do that with cancels, like, that shreds their life. It's crazy how strong that is. We've got Virgil coming up, and he's a big boss bonus. So, is anyone? Oh, Richie's live. What's Richie playing? Is he playing RE4? He is. All right. Okay. I think we'll go raid him. Go raid him after this mission. Yeah, we're going the right way. There we go. Yeah, these are another... I mean, these enemies aren't too bad. They're just kind of boring, but... They are a bit of a, like... You know... Really? They're pretty bland in terms of the overall enemy design in this game. Just a Flamin' Hot Mountain Dew when it's cold and tastes way better. Okay. You motherfucker. I also really prefer the Devil Trigger runes in DMC1. That was close. You can, we've only just, like, it's only, like, relatively recently that you can get Mountain Dew, in the UK. I've never tried it. I hate that. Shit. Hey, Faye, I just noticed Faye is on my... Oh yeah, did you guys know that they're getting rid of the friends thing on Twitch? For no real reason. I saw the update, like the post of it a while ago. And it's just, yeah! We're getting rid of the friends tab because... Well, we actually don't have a reason. Like... I don't know, man. I don't... The problem is... Well, the problem with what I'm about to say... Because I do think, like, I think there is definitely, like, enough people that would use it, to where, like, it would be a problem if anyone did it. Like, as in, like, set up a competitor to Twitch. Because I feel like a lot of the stuff they're doing, it's like, oh, you know, it's like, you're making it real easy to where, like, if there was a competitor, people would be like, yep, I'm all about it. I know I'm not usually a gunslinger person, but I will say, like, I do actually prefer gunslinger for spiders. Get off me. Oh, I was hoping I'd parry that. Gone now, right? No, I've still got it. Yeah, I can still see it. I think it's, I want to say it's May 25th. I think they're getting rid of it. And it's just weird because you say, like, you know, the post where they had, like, they just don't give a reason. They're like, yeah, we're just removing it. Like, this function that is actually quite useful and, you know, like, a huge part of, like, you know, a social aspect of this platform, we're just deleting it because reasons. Like, oh, okay, I thought the game crashed there. I just don't get it, man. It's really... So many real issues they could be fixing. Yeah, it is, yeah. There really is. But, you know. Twitch be Twitch. What can you do? Alright. Well, that's halfway through. Which is not bad. I do want to do Virgil just because I really want to get Beowulf, but we'll do that probably Monday, I think. Well, depending on how much I get done tomorrow, I might stream tomorrow, don't I? Oops. Alrighty then. There is too many things on this desk in the way of my keyboard. Yeah, it just seems like a very weird thing. I don't know, because Amazon own Twitch, don't they? And you think... I mean, I suppose there was Mixer, I guess. Like, you know, I say Microsoft tried, but I don't feel like they really gave it, like, long enough to really... And I feel like their approach as well, like, wasn't the best either. Their approach was just, hey, we're just gonna throw, like, crazy amounts of money at these, you know, at these big streamers and hope that works. Like, I feel like there are people at Microsoft that think, man, you know, what the fuck did we do with Mixer? Like, we fucked up. Like, why did we do that? Because, like, you think how much money they spent, like, getting the big streamers, and, like, they just went back to Twitch almost, like, within a year. It's crazy. Now, Major's on RE4. I know he's been playing a lot of RE4 lately, so I will never speed on RE4, but I do like watching the runs, so we're going to go raid Major. And, yeah, I'll catch you guys probably Monday. Maybe tomorrow, but don't hold your breath. So I've got some video stuff to do tomorrow. But we'll probably finish this run on Monday. And then, I don't know, we'll play somewhere else after that. So, yeah. Have a good day, guys. Enjoy your Saturday. And if I don't see you, enjoy your Sunday. I will catch you later in the week. Peace. There's a god of time right next to him, so because like the sword master throw is useful, but I feel like the feathers being like borderline undodgeable without DT is not good. Do I have to redo my controls again? Because I think I might just put them back, honestly. Oh, turbo is off. You know what? I think I'll leave that off. Yeah, default, there we go. Because honestly, like, that felt pretty awkward, so. But anyway, if 40% of the fingers, like, weren't fucking gimped on my hands, it wouldn't be such a big deal, but. That looked that was not intentional, but fucking hell, that looked sick. Just air-crossed all the arrows that he was gonna shoot at me. That was so cool. Yeah, like, not being able to use, like, my other hat, like, my other fingers is really annoying. Also, what's up, Hal? You know you can weapon switch cancel the rocket launcher? Yeah, you can. You can, like, cancel, like, anything in this game. I think about the only thing you can't cancel is, real impact. I'm trying to think of other moves that you can't cancel. Like, real impact's like the only one. Ooh. Don't let me forget to buy blue orbs in mission 12. Because that is why I'm having to redo it. Because my first Beowulf run was pretty good. Like, it was pretty clean. But, we have about, like, in the region of 60k, so. And here's the final control. Y is melee, B grapple, A is jump, X is gun, it is exceed left bumper. Right bumper is lock on, right trigger is buster, and the D-pad is... Oh, yeah, I went... Oh, man, I forgot about that. Yeah. I put it back to DMC4 controls, like, immediately. I can't... But yeah, Matt, really? Was the D-pad fucking... Devil trigger. Damn, I forgot about that. That's crazy. That's a really weird choice for Devil trigger, the D-pad. What the hell? I don't know. I'm gonna keep an eye out for DMC5 being on sale because I wouldn't mind playing through it again. Because I played that on Game Pass, and I haven't had like Xbox Live or Game Pass for a long time now. Even though I know I'm gonna hate V, although for that reason I'll probably look for it on PC, so then I can. How did that not get you? That didn't get a single one of them, did it? Alright. Please stop locking on to, like, the worst fucking enemy possible. I think you've been hanging out with Ryu, Dante. Get off me. Okay, that was lucky. That's much easier without holding down lock on. Like, much easier. Thing is, I can't get that without lock on, though. Because I don't have to, like, you know, hold down the lock on button with my ring finger. So for the Vanguard, I think, because then it's just like, just bang, bang, bang. It's very, very easy. Right, I gotta remember, this is melee, not this. So. Did I enjoy it? I didn't mind it, but I feel like it was a bit of a double... There was like a double header of... V is garbage in that. Like, I honestly do not understand why he's in the game, because he's just not fun. We'll move on from that. V is just shit. Like, don't play V. He's boring. But I think I'm just kind of tired of, like, the DMC formula at this point, to be honest. Fundamentally, like, these games haven't changed all that much since this one. You know? This game's 17 years old now. Like, that's pretty crazy. Like, that's pretty crazy to think, but... And if you've played a lot of them, like I have, like, it's just, I'm ready for them to do something else with it at this point. And I still don't think they've really beat this game yet, to be perfectly honest. I really don't. Even though, like, going back to this now, I feel like you notice some shortcomings that, like, weren't as apparent when it was new. But... I still think, like, at the core, this has the best combat in any DMC. Like, no game has, like, gotten, I think, like, the weapon balance and just the styles, like, the way everything just fits together in this game. I don't think, like, any other DMC has that. And I just wish they'd do something new, but they're not going to, you know? I honestly really don't like DMC5. It's weird, because it's... I feel like... Generally speaking, I feel like it's by far the most popular. You know? I feel like DMC5 seems to be, like, the DMC that really put... That, like, put DMC, like, on the map in a much better... In, like, a much, much bigger way. I don't know. And, this might rustle Jimmy's, but maybe because... It's an easier game. I don't know. Like, I feel like... I don't feel like it's really, like, I don't feel like it's a hot take to say that DMC5 is, like, significantly easier than, like, what came before it. Yeah, here, just do Ebony and Ivory cancels here, man. And that's not to say it's bad because it's easier, it's just, I think it just, you know, like using Royal Guard in DMC5, shit, nowhere near as satisfying as using it in 3 and 4, because, like, you don't have to work as hard to get. Yeah, see, without lock-on, that's, like, quite a bit easier to do. One thing I do hate about Bo is when he does this... When he just starts fucking jumping all over the place. Man, active frames. Okay, this might get me double trigger. If not... No, this is not gonna get me D2. I do need DT for that. I really need those green orbs. I keep doing it as well. Yeah, so like here, I would normally want to roll. There we go. But all I'm going to say is, who the fuck approved V? I don't know. The thing is, like, the reason I'm, like, somewhat apprehensive to totally throw him under the bus, but maybe when you really dig into that game, V is awesome. Because to be fair, I didn't. Which is unusual for DMC. But that's just because I didn't really enjoy DMC 5 all that much. But maybe if you dig into it, like, he's way more... He's way cooler, but I got all of his moves, and it's like he's not like he's underpowered. It's just he's just not fun. I don't know, you know. It's not necessarily that he sucks in that, you know, he doesn't play the game, because he does. He's just not that fun. It'd be like, yeah, because you have to lock on, otherwise it, so it'd be lock on like B swap. That there's no way I'm gonna be able to do that consistently. Yeah, we'll just keep Agni and Rudra. Mission 12. Wait, is this? Oh, yeah, so... I'm getting my missions mixed up here. I don't know who it was. It's just a video I saw. It's just a video I saw on YouTube, and I saved it because I'm hoping that, like, somewhere along the lines, it's explained how it actually is set up, because you would need to get the directions to register as an analog stick, and I don't know how you do that. But there's another thing too, the there's no shoulder buttons on a dance pad, so you'd like playing NG. You would have to remove like certain buttons and then go back and add them like when you need them. Like, so for example, like my first thought was to basically just play without projectiles and then put block on the B button. You know, and then I'm actually able to block. So like that's one thing. And then like for instances where you actually have to use a projectile, I would just go back into the options and, like, you know, and, like, put it back on B. It'd be tedious, but I don't really think there'd be any other... Because, like, you can't, like, play NG and, like, not block. You know what I mean? Like, oh, I should go spiral here. To be fair, yeah, like, picking yellow orbs just kind of habit. For this run, I probably should have gone with gold. But, you know, it all adds to the challenge. Please. Okay, all that. I mean, even doing that, like, is really not easy. And that's just one cancel. Like, to rapidly do it, like... Oh, and you're aiming at him, like... Great job, Dante. Definitely been hanging out with Ryu. Definitely. Speaking of Sekiro, that Rice Wine Duty beats NG Must Ninja with the Rock Band Drums is playing Sekiro with Rock Band Drums. Oh, nice. Yeah, I didn't finish watching that. I would like to finish that. It's cool. He emulated keyboard and mouse with the dance pad. Okay, so, I mean, if it, that's the thing, though, like, if it's possible, like, in theory, if it's possible to get it to work, like, if it's, you think, it's possible, so there's no reason why it shouldn't work for NG. In theory. Because I think that'd be a really fun run. I definitely try normal first. There's no way I'd try that on Master Ninja first. Because a huge part of that would just be... I mean, forget muscle memory. Like, it's weird when you play a game with a different controller. You know? That's like your entire body. You know, like, this is, like, kind of difficult enough. Just playing this on a stick versus playing on a pad. You know, playing NG where, like, you have to be like, oh, okay, I have to literally dance to do my combos. That's gonna, you know, there's gonna be a learning curve there. There we go. But it could be a lot of fun, though. I feel like that's a perfect example of, like, you know, like, the style system and, like, how it actually works. Because, like, even to this day, and, you know, it's not entirely false, it's just, you know, the idea that it's all about variety, it's like, no, it's about how many things your attacks hit, like, predominantly. Because there, you can literally just do spiral, that, like, nothing but spiral shots, and if it hits enough enemies, like, you get absolutely zero style to go. And not only decay, like, you know, it actually goes up. Like, you'll just get on SSSS and, like, stay on it forever. It's one of those things. NG with Guitar Hero. What? I don't know if that'd be possible, though, because on Guitar Hero, like, do you even have, like, do you even have, like, directions on Guitar Hero? Like, the strum isn't directions, is it? There we go. Because you've got, you know, you've got face buttons, but... if you can't move, then, like, that's a problem. All something for probably next year at this point. Because thinking of, like, how much I've got left to do on, like, Resident Evil, like, there's a lot of shit left on my Resident Evil to-do list. There's a lot left. So... It's something that I've literally, like, labbed in my head. I've thought about, like, how I would actually do, like, an Izuna drop on a dance pad. And it's like, I'm like, yeah, this could work. It'd be weird, but this could totally work. How much... You know what? I might just totally cheap out here. Then again, holy waters are pretty expensive, aren't they? Well, I've already got two. Let's just buy one. I don't know how much damage holy waters do on this. So... No, NG doesn't have keyboard and mouse support. No, it doesn't. That's the main thing why I'm wondering, like, you know, is it doable? But yeah, there's emulation. Like, do it that way, yeah. The tilt registers is a right stick, so you'd have to swap sticks, and the strum bar is up, down on the D-pad. Yeah, so... Man, that's crazy. When's the normal no damage, no block run? Oof, man. Whenever you want to make it, man. I ain't doing that shit. I mean, it's definitely possible, it's just, like, I mean, like, single segment, I don't know, actually, like, I think, because it's weird now, like, I think that's kind of the weird thing with TGD's run, like, because, he, like, that run's actually been brought down now, like, the idea of doing like a segmented no damage run on normal is like, well, why, like, you know, that's kind of small potatoes now, because, you know, the whole game has been done, like, in one go. Escalation, you know? I feel like it's been getting there for a while, and, like, the no damage, no info, no UT run of Master Ninja has kind of done that to Master Ninja. It's like, no damage, no nimpo used to be like, you know, holy shit, like, that's an insane run. You know, now it's like, well, like, you can make this run a lot fucking harder if you really want to. Not that no damage, no nimpo is like easy, but like, it's certainly easier than no damage, no nimpo, no UT. Right, there we go. Yeah, what's up, Kreitz? It really was, yeah. The whole port was lazy. Oh shit, I just remembered. I have to like fucking... Alright. Yeah, I'm gonna double trigger here. Because I have to swap this to the D-pad to be able to do this. Okay, I was hoping that'd do more damage, I'm not gonna lie. Is he stunned now? Oh shit. There we go. See, I can't fucking get over to him because I have to swap back. Oh, that sucks. It's weird, for as popular as, like, you know, like, no damage stuff and that is, like... it's a shame that, you know, like, NG is, like, not more popular. This is not a good idea. I want to, like, you can just jump on his back if you time it right. There we go. This, like, until I really... you know, sussed Royal Guard. Like, this is exactly how I fought. I used to fight this guy. It was just jump on his back and do combos. Whoops. I wouldn't go as far as to say he's a terrible boss, but on a first playthrough, I would say he's a pretty terrible boss. Because you think on a first playthrough, like, you don't really have the stuff you really want for him. Like, best case scenario, your Royal Guard's gonna be level 2. Which is enough, but, you know. You're not gonna perfect Royal Guard this guy on your first run, you know what I mean? Like, that takes a wee bit of practice. Oh. There we go. I don't understand how people find no nimpo, no damage, no G runs so impressive, even on Master Ninja. Try it. Try it and you will. Like, you know. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't, like, but then again, this is me talking, so you know, take it with a pinch of salt, but like, they've never been, like, crazy impressive to me. And I'm not saying that as a dig on anyone that's done one, but, like, there are certain fights that are impressive to do with those limitations, but you know what I mean? It's you've done no damage, no nimpo, no UT. Like, no offense, man, but like, unless that's on video, like, you know, you're gonna have to have videos for that one. Yeah, like, Awakened Alma, Nishe, Ishtaros, Mob, like, the bosses, pretty much, you know. I haven't finished it, but I got to Alma pretty easily, all things considered. That's kind of where those runs get hard, though. Like, Alma onwards is where, like, that run gets quite difficult. Like, chapters 1 through 6. Like, that was one thing on, even on the, like, no damage, no info, no UT. Like, until I got to chapter 7, like, that run really wasn't that difficult. It wasn't free, but I was like, ah, you know, like, I'm getting through this, you know, pretty consistently. And then chapter 7 comes along and is like, hey, Man, it took me an hour to do two missions. That was fucking terrible. Oops. Yeah, it really is, yeah. And I don't even know. And here's the funny thing as well. And I mentioned this in one of TGD's streams not long ago. Like, honestly, unless you just really want to do it for, like, the challenge, no damage, no nimpo, no UT, it's not that fun. It's really not. Which is a shame to say, but, like, it's really not actually that enjoyable of a run. Like, the satisfaction of like, completing it, like, is fun. And for me, like figuring out, like, how to do it was fun. But, I mean, I dare say, like, if anyone else tries that run, I mean, you know, if they don't want to, that's on them. But, like, if they don't want to, like, you know, look into, like, my videos for strategies, like, I commend them for doing it themselves. But, you'd save yourself a lot of headaches if you did. And, like, that was fun. If I was to do the run again, you know, I'd definitely do it sooner. I'd definitely do it in less time. But apart from the big five, like, the run was kind of frustrating. And, like, you know, just kind of a pain. There we go. I've done no damage to an NGP on Master Ninja, and it wasn't even easy with Nimpo. Yeah, but I mean, that's going to depend. Like, your mileage will vary on that, you know. Like, it depends on the player. It really does. Like, for me, a no damage run would not be hard. It just wouldn't be. And, like, I'm not trying to be like, yeah, I'm the best. Fuck all of you bitches. Like, I would be being facetious if I was to be like, yeah, that's really difficult. Like, because it just wouldn't be that difficult for me. What is this? Ah, Devil Star, nice. Speaking of NG, or speaking of DMC and NG, I really hope TGD does get back to that. There we go. I really hope TGD does get back to that, like, full game, like, SS no damage run of 4. That would be an amazing fucking run to see. I don't think, like, that's a funny thing, because, like, most people now, like, I feel like that's really not how they, like, tend to play DMC. Like, the emphasis is, like, either on speed or style. Doing the entire game in one sitting, SS no damage, that is a pretty insane challenge. It's definitely doable, but, like, man, it'd be hard. It'd be very hard. Right. Oh no, crap. That's the wrong way. I fucked up. That also made me significantly better at the game, since I never really have done that. Yeah, it will do. And that's the thing about challenge runs, and that's why I kind of always, you know, champion them, is that they do make you significantly better. I must admit, I am drawing a total blank on this one. Oh no, there we go. No, we just got it. That's why they're so much fun, because they make you understand, like, they make you understand things you didn't realize, like, you might not have understood, you know, until you did them. What is this originates from? Yeah, it originates from the statue. Yeah. Right, okay. Let me try that again. Matt, it's been a while since I've done this. Hey, what's up, Matt? Man. if anyone can remember this, like, feel free to tell me, because honestly, I haven't done this in fucking years, and I'm totally brain farting on this right now. Yeah, so it starts from here. Oh, hang on, don't you? You can reset it with this, right? Yeah. Oh no, I'm... Oh my god, I totally forgot. There we go. I thought you had to get it to this, and I was like, wait, that's... Is that even possible? There we go. There we are. No wonder that was so difficult. That's not where it needs to go. Oh man. Oh, dude. You dislike most of the bosses? Why is that? I'm curious to know. Why don't you like the NG bosses? Most games aren't pushing games to the limit. Even beating Master Ninja is probably a low... Yeah, it's true, yeah. That's where, like, achievement and trophy percentage stuff is... like, really interesting these days. Like, I don't know if anyone else really cares about that stuff, but probably not. But I find it really interesting. Like, you go and look at most games, the amount of people that barely finish a game, like, is insane these days. It's really crazy. Like, if you complete a game and have a look at, like, the percentage of people that have actually got, like, the beat the game trophy, it's fucking nuts. Like, I'd say, like, if it's above 20%, that's pretty crazy, yeah. Why isn't this working? Is there something missing? How come you never said things to Farnum? What are you talking about? Now, this guy is going to be tricky. Because I need to time my double trigger explosions on him when he goes into DT. You will not forget this devil's power. This is going to be fucking awkward. Ah, shit. There we go. Okay. I actually really have to think here. Like, this combo needs to be, like, very precise. Because I don't think that's actually, like, a guaranteed knockout of his devil trigger, but I can't take the risk that it isn't. There we go. Ooh. And this is really not comfortable to press. Nah. I don't think I've got enough runes, like, for that to just knock him out in one hit. I thought I did, but... up. Okay, that was almost not good. So, the way you fight them is really passive? Not necessarily. Fighting, being aggressive in NG just in general, like, is a lot harder than people realize. Because you really have to know a lot more to, like, NG playing defensive, I think, is a much easier game. Like, in general. And I think that's why people, when they're new to it, like, have a lot of trouble. Because they're trying to be aggressive, but they don't know enough about the enemies to really be able to do that. So. I don't feel like engaging to dodge their attacks. Yes. Most of the time, you're just waiting at long distance for them to give you a punishable attack. Yeah, not really. Like, yeah, like, not really. Like, that's just, like, I'm thinking, like, Mirai, you can fight toe-to-toe. You can fight Masakado toe-to-toe. Dynamo, you can fight toe-to-toe, no problem. Hydrocubus, you can fight toe-to-toe, no problem. Bone Dragon, no pun intended, but you can fight him toe-to-toe, no problem. I've got all the best puns. Alma to a certain extent, you can fight Alma super aggressive, but you're just not necessarily guaranteed, like, you know. Shit, I forgot to pick up fucking, oh my god, I'm going fucking senile. I forgot to pick up fucking Bone Wolf. These are the only two missions I'm really not a fan of either. I don't really like mission 14 and 15, but there we go. Yes, now we can play the game properly. So, being more aggressive is just harder and is rarely worth it. Well, yeah, you've hit the nail on the head, though. It is significantly harder, but it's definitely worth it. Definitely worth it. That's when you see people that are new to NG, like, that's kind of where they fall down. Is, like, for example, like, when people get a hit on Alma, perfect example, right? What do most people do? Alma's on the floor and they just mash X and they get a 3-hit string, which is like garbage damage. Whereas, like, if you know Alma and know how to fight her, you can either do a launcher, or you can do a stagger and a launcher, or you can do a stagger into a launcher into a relaunch, like, if you know what to do. It's just, you just have to know. Right. Let's get Beowulf here. I'm not going to bother getting that, because I really need it. There we go. Right, that's much better. So that's one more. Well, it is. Like, it absolutely is. Like, go and watch the speed kills of bosses on my channel of Ninja Gaiden and, like, tell me that they're not aggressive. Like, you know what I mean? Like, and that's one, and that's, yeah, and that's Alma. Like, and I already said, like, Alma is, like, you know, not, like, aggression's not necessarily great against her. But let's carry on going through the list. The tanks, absolutely, it's best to be aggressive. It's just really hard to do it. The helicopter, best to be aggressive. It's just really hard to do it. The worms, definitely best to be aggressive. You have to respect their attacks, for sure, but that's true of any action game. Like, you can't just walk up to a boss in Devil May Cry and just start hitting buttons and win. Like, to a certain extent, you're always going to have to wait for your window to attack a boss or an enemy. Like, that's, I feel like that's just action games, full stop. Right. This is mission 14. Mission 15 is the one I really have to remember on, because it's forward, forward, back, forward in terms of going through the doors. Should have actually got I should have actually stuck with Agni and Rudra here. Now that I think about it. Dante, why would you fucking aim at him? You clown. I don't get what you're talking about, Hal. Like, what have I said that's a double standard? Like, I have no idea what you're talking about. Don't hate on him. Like, he's not saying NG sucks, he's just saying what he thinks, and it, like, don't be like, oh, you suck because you haven't played this game for, like, fucking a billion hours like we have. Like, don't be like that. Come on, people. This chat's better than that. Oh, not me, right. Sorry, I thought you meant, like, I was saying, like, contradicting stuff, and I was like, what? Like, what have I said? Like, I'm making sense here. Okay, I'm with you now. Yeah. I've said this before, you know, don't get clouded by your enthusiast glasses, you know? It's a very easy mistake to make, but it's, like, you know, you, like, there's stuff about DMC that bothers me that I'm sure doesn't bother, like, Breyer or Donguri, like, because they know the game much better than I do, you know? And that's, like, part of it with NG. Like, a lot of your frustration comes from just not knowing stuff. Hey, what's up, Morgan? Welcome. Okay, right, I'm with you now. I see. I misunderstood. You know, I just thought, I don't have a level 3 Swordmaster here, so I don't have real impact. So yeah, I'm actually going to go back to Agni and Rudra. Okay, let's see how well I can do this. Not bad. Again, easier, like, without locking on. I don't know if that's just, like, the sheer amount of, like, Killer Bee cancelling I've done over the years, but that feels way easier than doing, like, air cross cancels, so. I'm just trying to find a reason why I figure out the boss is boring for the most part. Well, here's a good question for you, then. Like, throw out a boss that you find boring and say why, and then I can probably, like, give you some info on to make it more fun. Like, perfect example, when I first played NG, this is the benefit of, like, not streaming your first playthrough. When I got to the tanks, I got fucking slaughtered by them and was like, oh, this is stupid, these tanks are dumb, like, this is the worst boss ever, like, you know, total, like, just, you know, complaining, like, you know, like, this is shit. And then I got up to very hard on, like, NG04 and was like, okay, like, this cannon is killing me in, like, 2 fucking shots. I really need to, like, pay attention here and figure out what to do. And then, you know, it got easier. But that said, like, you never know, like, you're never gonna, like, know everything, even with the amount of time, like, even someone like me has. It's, you know, again, like, be aware of your enthusiast glasses, because they can blind you. And always be open to learning new shit. Even if you think you're the master, it's better to assume that you're actually a scrub. Because a scrub can learn. Someone who, like, thinks, no, I'm just the best, bro. That person's not gonna learn. That's much easier. Hey, what's up, TGD? Yeah, doing good, yeah. This is, like, not as smooth in the second half as the first half. Not being able to roll, like, super tightly is kind of awkward. Well, annoying as well. And, yeah, just having to think more about, like, the button prompts and that, you know? And I fucked up because, like, Rebellion and Beowulf is kind of my, like, go-to combo on this game. And I forgot, like, one of the main reasons to have Beowulf is real impact if you don't have that until level 3. So I should have actually have upgraded Agni and Rudra, and that would have made, like, previous missions a lot less annoying. I do love doing those cancels, though, yeah. It's so cool. The tanks are one of my... Tanks are really cool, yeah. Fiend Mariah I find boring. Why, though? Because the only way to damage him safely is with UTs. To be fair, that's true. Like, that's a fair point. The only way to, like, 100% safely damage him... And I've said this before, like, Fiend Mariah is probably one of the only bosses in NGB that is, like, somewhat flawed as in terms of design. Like, the fact that you literally cannot hit him safely without Nimpo is kind of shitty. Like, because he can just cancel at any point and counter you. Alright, now, no camera control doesn't help here either. If he did something, like Dive Bomb, for example, like, you can damage him then, but he can still just hit you in recovery. Alright, my memory's never good for this shit. Here we are. Like, Killer Bee's better for them, but... You know one thing I like that still bugs me about this game is how nerfed Meteor is compared to DMC1. Like, Meteor is so good in DMC1, and it's such a garbage move in this game. So...
I seem to be someone who really got into NG. I'm really impressed. Oh, thanks, Morgan. I appreciate that.
Like, impressing people is not my goal, though. Helping people is my goal. Like, the best comment you get is when people are like, oh, I was getting bodied by this, and this really helped. And, like, most of that is, like, tutorial stuff. And, I mean, it's been a few years now, but, like, that's kind of what, like, most of my, like, 2012 and onwards videos, like, have been is tutorial stuff. Whoops. I'm getting greedy. He says, and then he keeps doing it. Yeah, like, having to think for that is, like, just killing me inside. It should just be instant. So.
I find normal Mirai also a bit boring due to being limited.
Normal. Yeah, normal Mirai is not, like, the most intriguing, but he's still a fun boss. Like, normal Mirai is like a poke game in a fighting game in a lot of ways. It's like, once, like, it's all about range. And getting that punish on him. And, like, and not mashing. Like, if you mash, like, he'll counter you. You know? And then... And I think that's something that is... I'm trying to think of other games that do it. I think Metal Gear Rising had bosses that did that, but I wouldn't swear to that. But, like, enemies actually countering you. Like, enemies being able to parry you. And, like, punish you for, like, mashing. Here we are.
In that case, I was struggling with the Fire Dragon. Your video helps a lot. Oh, nice. Good, thanks.
Now, there's one I would agree with, actually. Shmorgon kind of sucks. If you think about it. Like, he's not a great boss, really. He's really not. Like, he's one of those... It's weird. He's one of those, like, action game, like, floaty head bosses, if you know what I mean. You know? Where, like, if he didn't put his head near you, you wouldn't really be able to hit him. Like, ever. Like... He's a weird boss in that regard. Especially in NGO4. Yeah, I don't think anyone's going to be like, yeah, Shmorgon's like one of the best bosses in NGB. And it's, say, in NGO4, it's even worse, because in NGO4, like, he's virtually immune to projectiles, and you can't charge UTs in that game, so you literally just, like, stand there and just wait for him to, like, you know, put his head in front of you and hit him. Then it's like, oh, okay. You know, if you didn't do that, I wouldn't be able to hit you. Yeah, I think we'll go with Agni and Rudra here. Jetstream. Oh no, I probably should have bought Air Hike. Never mind. At least I have Stinger on both now. Are there any other bosses? Because that's only two. I just feel most people's frustration in general in NGB just comes from, like, a lack of knowledge. And I don't mean that as a dig, it's just, like, it is what it is. Yeah, I should've, I wanted Air Hike, like, specifically for these guys.
Awakened Iron Wings just grappling projectile spam, where you do a whole lot of just rolling and jumping at a specific angle to the left.
There's way... That's a gross oversimplification of Awakened Iron Wings, though. Like, it's not exactly wrong, but... It's... You know. Like you could reduce Virgil in this game to be like, well, yeah, just wait for the window and stinger him. And it's like, well, yeah, like, that's true, but, like, there is more to the fight than that. You know?
The video on the Centipede Fiend boss helped. Which one's that?
Centipede Fiend? What do you mean?
Centipede?
I'm really, like... Do you mean the worm? Centipede. I'm trying to think of centipede boss. There we go. The floating pink one. Oh, you mean awakened Alma? Set man, I've never. Yeah, I suppose. Yeah, there is. She's got like the millipede legs. Yeah. Yeah, the centipede boss. Yeah. Centipede. Just gonna call awakened Alma the centipede boss from now on. I like that. Yeah, but there's much more. Yeah, there is, but there's much more to Awakened Alma than that. Like, you make it seem like dodging Awakened Alma is, like, super easy, and it's not. Like, flawlessly dodging that boss, like, is not an easy thing to do. And she's another one where, like, people's, like, when you actually get an attack on her, like, a lot of the time people don't capitalize on their openings. The same is true with Virgil. Like, if you're hitting Virgil, I mean, most people probably know this, but the best thing to hit Virgil with is single hit moves that don't cause knockback. Because if you high time or stinger Virgil, then that counts as 2 points. Here's some like in depth DMC3 shit for you. But as far as I remember, Virgil has like 13 stun points when you stun him, like when he's doing like a judgment call or something like that. So that's why you want to do Killer B cancels, because Killer B only counts as 1 point on that system. So you can get 13 Killer Bs on him. Whereas if you did this combo, that would count as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You'd get this combo twice on him, because high time and stinger count as like a launch or a knockback move. Same thing with Awakened Alma. If you get her knocked down and you do like a short combo, or you don't go for Renox, or you don't go for hits after Fireball, or you don't go for hits when she runs at you, like, you're not making the most of your openings.
I don't see that it's pretty easy. Is it not pretty easy to do?
I don't do this often, but I feel like if I'm saying it's not easy, I would like to think that carries a little bit of weight. You know? Like, dodging her flawlessly is not easy to do. Like, you can't just autopilot that.
It's just memorizing the predator.
That's any boss, though. Like, that's literally any attack any boss does in any game, is memorizing patterns for their moves. Like, that... Name one action game where that doesn't apply to the boss. Like... I mean, that applies to games, like, full stop, pretty much. Like, it's just memorizing patterns. Case in point, this one. I always forget where to fucking go in this mission, which is why I don't like it. Even when I played this regularly, I'd be like, okay, what do I do? Like, so, right. So, that. Oh, yeah. Yeah, no, we're going backwards, aren't we? I'm going backwards here, yeah. I guess it's just a totally execution fight. What are you talking about? Awakened Alma? Not really any reaction time involved. Well, yeah, but, like, again, isn't that basically every fight? Like, isn't that basically any boss? Like, there aren't many games I can think of that have, like, because if you're talking reaction times, like, you're talking in, like, the sub-25 frame region. Not many games have attacks that quick on their bosses. Like, most games, it's pretty telegraphed. Otherwise, like, people just wouldn't be able to fucking do them. Like, for example, like, the attacks in NG that, like, are, like, sub-20 frames, you can still react to them. They're just... very, very, like, not everyone can do that. You know, not everyone can actually react that quickly. They, people say they will, but they won't. Waking down was grab. Also, I put on that list. Like, that grab catches people out all the time. All the time. If anyone's going to be like, oh, that grab never hits me. Like, nah. Like, you might dodge it 9 times out of 10, but it definitely hits you sometimes. You know what I mean? Oops. Yes, I have. I've played a lot of Dead or Alive. I love DOA. I just kind of stopped playing it after 4, to be honest. I played because I didn't have online back then. So played a lot of DOA 4 with just, you know, people that were around me at the time. Like, we just played offline. You know, really loved it. But like after that, like as soon as like people stopped playing it, it was like, okay, like got no one to play this with now. Like,
I wish we had more hard to react to.
You know what? Honestly, I agree with that, but the older I get, I am less inclined to agree with it. But I know what you mean. Like, certain things are very easy to react to. Like, most of the time, stuff's fairly lenient. And I feel like that's where, like, your older games, you know, like, the reaction stuff, like, they expect you to be able to react very quickly. I'd say, like, if it's, like, 25, if it's in the region of, like, 25 frames, that's, if you can react to that every time, like, that's good. You've got above average reaction times for sure. And everyone will say they will, but you know, they don't. Everyone's like, I can react 10 frames, bro. Like, no you can't. It's just no you can't. It'd be nice if we were superhuman. But
the way bosses can be difficult is having to make complex decisions.
Yeah, that's true, but I'm trying to, like, off the top of my head, I'm trying to think of games that really do that. And here's the thing with that, right? Don't you think this is kind of the rub with this? Like, bosses are only hard up until a certain point when you are new to fighting them. Most bosses, I'm trying to think now in my head, like, what's up, Riga, by the way? I'm trying to think of bosses in my head now, like, in a game that are still, like, You still have to sit up in your chair to fight them, do you know what I mean? You know, you get to a boss and you're like, right, okay, I gotta pay attention here. Most bosses, I feel like, once you, like, figure them out, you're like, right, well, this is free. And that's just, you know, a downside, I guess, of, like, the more you play a game. Like, Nightmare's a good example in DMC1. Like, until I really understood Nightmare, and even now, like, you gotta pay attention on Nightmare, but you know, not nearly as much as when I first played it. I'm trying to think of other games that kind of have that. I guess the clone Ryus in NG count, but that's just because they're kind of busted. Like, the clone Ryus can be wise guys when they want to be. Namely the flail clone. Right, so yeah, this mission always takes me fucking ages. So yeah, I haven't played the Souls game, so I can't really comment on them. I fought, like, a grand total of, like, 2 bosses in the Souls games, so. Here's a question, though. Like, are they, though? Because I bet if you look for, I bet there are videos of people, like, destroying bosses in, like, 1 combo, right? I bet that is possible to do if you know how. So, it's kind of like the low health UF problem in NG. Like when people understand the boss enough to use the low health UF on it, like that like said boss becomes like a total joke because you're like, well, I'm just gonna low health UF this boss and GG's. You know, getting to that point might take a while, but once you're at that point, you know, it's like, This boss is free. I hate going backwards through this.
I think that's fine with bosses that don't have a hard to react to or hard decisions. I get bored by the boss.
I feel like that's any enemy, I think, falls. Like, that's not exclusive to, like, boss enemies. Here's a good question, actually, on this topic. What are some enemies that are, like, totally boss-worthy? Because I can think of a few in games. Like, where like you play an action game and like there's just a regular enemy and you think, man, in most other action games, like this enemy would be a boss. Like this would legit be a boss fight. And certain certain games will do that. You know, like you're like the Resetsu in NG2, for example. He's a boss, and then at a certain point in the game, like he's just an enemy. Like you just fight him, you know, all the time. You're like, right, like this enemy has like been demoted. I feel like shadows in DMC1. I feel like are a pretty good nod for that. Like those guys, like man, like if you don't learn how to fight them, they will just kill you over and over and over again. I feel like the death scissors and death scythes as well, because in DMC, like, they kind of start out as, like, mini-bosses, and then you just get them, like, willy-nilly. Here we are. That also comes with a lot of knowledge and practice. Yeah, it does, yeah. A DS no damage runs are as oversaturated as Guitar Hero. DS no damage. Oh, you mean Dark Souls? I thought you meant Dragon Sword no damage runs. I thought, dude, really? I've not seen that. Okay, I think this is the wrong way, isn't it? Oh, man, No, I've got them all. I was gonna say I thought I had all. Okay, right, cool, never mind. We're out of here. Dark Souls no damage runs. Are they really that common? I have watched a couple, but they tend to go through a lot of their stuff. You know, like they're equipping stuff, and they tend to go through all that stuff like super fast. And you're like, okay, I have to like slow the video down to like see what he's actually doing in terms of like his loadout, like, you know. Yeah, I love that. That kick is, I think you get that when, like, Dante's back is to an enemy. And it's like the kick in NGB where, like, you kick a headless enemy away from you. So I just wish it was a regular move you could do whenever you wanted to. Alchemist in Razor's Edge? Yeah, I haven't played them, sorry. Hearing about a new no damage run for Dark Souls is like, oh, the 700th one. Is that a bit of an exaggeration? I don't know. Again, not played them, so. I did install Dark Souls 1 on PC, though. Because I remembered that I own that. There are just too many, and it's nothing special. It's to the point where casual players are doing them. Grads from Metal Gear Rising. Oh, that's a good one. Can we talk about Metal Gear Rising? That's a good game. Has anyone played that? Or a better question, has anyone not played that? And if the answer is no, then you should. I think 700 people have no damage Dark Souls by this point. Man. Huh. Well. I guess that. What can you say, really? There you go. If they have, they have. Maybe they've just, like, you know, got it. You know, they've got it, like, that game is just that well dug out. And I don't know, because I haven't really played them, but, you know, the people that have played them, like, would you say they are designed with no damage in mind? Because I would imagine, just from the brief stint I've had with them, like, they kind of are. I can't imagine, again, correct me if I'm wrong, but I can't imagine there's, like, sequences in that where, like, we're an NG, where, like, you can be put in a situation where, like, without Nimpo, or, like, just depending on, like, poor decision-making, like, you can get into a situation where, like, you're gonna have, like, two attacks coming at you, and, like, one of them is going to hit you. You just have to choose which one is gonna hit you. Not him. I should have got Air Hike for Agni and Rudra. Any, like, keen Souls players in the chat? Metal Gear Rising is the best Platinum game. I could agree with that. I feel like the one thing that makes me like quite biased towards Rising is that like Platinum and Bayonetta are like sick, don't get me wrong. Platinum and Bayonetta and Vanquish rather are super good, but they're story wise, like they're nothing, you know, nothing special. Whereas I think Metal Gear Rising, like, its story is just, it's so crazy and so, like, just so dumb that you just, it gets a lot of extra, like, brownie points for me. I just thought the shotgun would actually have been better here, but, because, you know, like, super close. There's literally... Oh, there's some... Are we talking about Dark Souls still? Maybe Grace and Glory from Bayonetta? Yeah, that's a really good pick, actually, yeah. I like, in a lot of other games, like, they would definitely be a boss.
You can AI manipulate that of doing certain moves. Souls game, okay. I don't find the Souls games overly... What's up, Fist? But I don't enjoy the combat. Neo and Bloodborne are better combat experiences, though.
I feel like most people tend to be kind of on that side of the fence, in that, like, Neo and Bloodborne are, like, better in terms of just sheer combat. Has anyone played... Like, how is Elden Ring? Like, in terms of combat, I mean. Like, is Elden Ring, like, you know, that different to the Souls stuff? Or does it play it pretty safe? Oops, I've got... Yeah. I'm gonna say, why aren't I shooting? That was a real deer in headlights moment. Like, I thought that was gonna hit me, and yet I still just stood still anyway. And then the other thing hit me. Like... Yeah, like, doing that, like, it's so much easier when you don't lock on, which is, like, so alien. Like, just feels so weird to say that. Remind me to swap to Beowulf. Elden Ring is just Dark Souls 4. Same as Dark Souls 3. You have a jump button. Well, I mean, surely that does make the game, like, quite different, right? Like, genuine question. Like, do you have air... Like, do you have air moves? Like, do you have air combos? Like, can you do attacks in the air? Or is it just, like, jump? Can you just jump for, like, movement? Basically. But even so, like, surely that, like, really changes that game. I would imagine. I would assume. Like, being able to jump, you know, pretty big deal. No jump run of NGB. There you go. Do a no jumping run.
But it's boring and overhyped as fuck.
That's probably because the combat is ass. Fair enough. I feel like Elden Ring is kind of one of those games, though. Like, I feel like It's like Marmite, you know? Like, you either love it or you're like, nah, fuck this shit. But. There we go. You have a jump and stab down move. Alright. You could jump into Sekiro, so they just added that to Elden Ring. Alright. Yeah, I've not played Sekiro either. That does look kind of cool, though. I would like to try that. You know what game I really want to play, just for the aesthetic, though? Like, and if they ever do, like, a remaster or a PC version, like, I'll probably buy it. I don't care. But it's Bloodborne. I'd love to play that, but, like, that... I did try it on PS4. And just... Ugh. The performance is rough on PS4. Have I got... No, I have got... Because that seems like a little bit more... Like, aggression seems more kind of focused in that game. Like, the way you can get health back, you know, like, with in like, an attack window. I do like that idea. It just feels not great to play.
You could do jump attacks. I believe it's one of the best ways to play is that jumping attacks are OP. Plus one for PC Bloodborne. You can play Bloodborne on PSX for free. I've got it. I actually have it from PlayStation Plus, yeah. It's just, again, it's just kind of rough. You can stream Bloodborne on PC with PlayStation Now. Is that any better, though? Yeah, I wouldn't imagine. I don't think I'd want to play it like that, but, you know. Imagine if we could get Carl Jobs to make a video about TGDs. He wouldn't, though. Because, I mean... You think about... I mean, I don't know if anyone, like, doesn't know who that is, but... He's a pretty, like, predominant, like, speedrunning, like, challenge run, like, covering channel. And he's only going to cover the stuff that is, like, mass appealing, you know? Or, like, is... That a lot of people do. He did the NES NG games. He did, but I feel like they're more simple to explain. Because the things with, like, a lot of his videos... And also, he'd have to learn the game, like... reasonably well. Like, that's one thing I do like about his videos. Like, if he doesn't, like, know the game, like, he actually does put a lot of time into it and play it to, like, learn it. I'm actually gonna grab some health here. Whereas, like, NG, I don't know. I feel like you would need to really put a lot of time in to, like, fully comprehend that. He's got a big enough channel to where, like, it, you know, don't get me wrong, it would definitely help, but I don't feel like it would, that's one thing that I just don't really agree with that mentality. Like, that's not going to be the thing that, like, gets a game to take off and get, like, super popular, you know? Because you know what's, like, a much more realistic expectation if that ever happened? Let's say tomorrow, like, Ninja started streaming, Ninja Gaiden, right? And everyone started playing it. Yeah, a lot of people would play it, and a lot of people would get to Mirai and get fucking bodied, and then they never play it again. Like, you know, like, they wouldn't carry on playing it. Even games now that have got, like, a pretty decent following that didn't used to, like DMC's got a pretty decent scene now, like, for speedrunning and challenge runs and that, but you compare DMC to... I mean, I'm trying to think of any game, but, like, any game that's, like, remotely big on YouTube or Twitch, like, it's nothing. Like, you know, DMC has got nothing on those games. It's just, you know, it's big for, like, Devil May Cry, you know? I do like that, like... You deal so much damage to Lady. Like, even on DMD, like, you deal a shitload of damage to Lady. Because if she was tanky, I'd be like, come on. She's literally a human being. Like, why is she able to tank my hits? You know? Where have you gone? There you are.
This might kill. Yeah, there we go.
I just remember my first Ninja Gaiden game was on the DS. That's a great game, though. Yeah, it really is good. Yeah. Clarification, I don't like Elden Ring that much, but the combat system is cool. I find it amazing how easily impressed people seem these days. I mean, Lady D sold Resident Evil 8.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, marketing, man. You know, like, there's a conversation there. Like, I mean, look, and again, like, I'm not saying DMC5 sucks, but, you know, it doesn't. DMC5 is a good game, but Capcom, the main reason I think DMC5 did so well was that it was just marketed super well. Like, they really promoted that game well. They made it appealing. They made it cool. They made people that, you know, weren't DMC fans be like, oh, like, what's up with that DMC5? Like, that looks pretty cool. And it worked. So that's still, I think, one of the biggest missteps that, like, Tecmo and that did with the Master Collection. The marketing for that, like, the marketing for the Master Collection was terrible. It was, I mean, for the main reason that there was hardly any of it. Like, there wasn't a whole lot of marketing for that game. And, like, what there was wasn't very good. Now then, that purple orb's pretty expensive. I don't think I'm going to buy that. I want to get Air Hike with Agni and Rudra, actually. I don't mind. Lady can be kind of annoying, but she's not too bad, yeah.
I feel like TG got the DMD, no damage SSS, can't wait to have it on that.
Maybe, but I still think that game has a lot to understand to, you know, to get across in that kind of video. I don't know. And this is where, like, I suppose, you know, being, like, somewhat, like, ignorant when it comes to the Souls series. Like, 'cause I know he's done a lot of videos on the Souls games, but, like, I've watched them, and I'm like, yeah, like, I don't really know the games well enough, and there are people that, like, don't agree with that, because he did a video on, like, the Dark Souls no damage runs, and there are people in the comments that are like, like, you know, this isn't hard, and I think, well, okay, like, you know, you can't please everyone, man. This was the wrong door. Oh well.
Who's your main in DOA?
And why is it Zach? I did play a lot of Zach. I mean, it, like, my main in DOA should be pretty easy. I feel like if you have to ask that question. But Zach was a legit secondary. Zach is the Bruce Lee guy, right? You can get three there if you're quick enough. Like, when he comes out the ground. Like, if you're really on point with your jump cancels, you can get three air crosses on him. Please get stunned. Thank you. Nice to have Air Hike back. Like, with both my weapons. Almost! Almost got three on that one.
Forget the Souls games. Where's my new Tenchu? I take a new Tenchu. Everyone collect it.
Really? Oh, did they? Did people? Oh, okay. That's news to me. As in, like, it's not that hard, or, like, it was a bad video?
I know who your main is, Hayate.
Bruh. Hayate is a bitch. Although, he's annoying because he's, like, hella good.
Zach is the black guy? Oh, isn't he?
Who's... No, who's... What? God. I'm getting old, man. Jan Lee, that, yeah, yeah, thank you. Yeah, Jan Lee's the Bruce Lee guy, yeah. Yeah. I don't know why I thought it was Zach. I'm curious, like, Momiji. It's almost like the video is sarcastic. Really? Because I did watch it, but I didn't read the comments and say, like, I don't know the Souls games, but, like... Oh, that's, not to, like, dig into it, but I'm curious, like, what was the main reason why? He just said many things that are just wrong, like, the games are always fair. Okay. Hmm. Okay. No, I'm probably not going to go and look at the comments, but I wasn't aware of that. MK Shaolin Monks Remaster. Yes. I should have swapped to Trickster here. Hang on. Yeah, I'm going to. I'm not going to fucking subject myself to that. Shaolin Monks 2. That's what we need. We need a Shaolin Monks sequel. Say it with me. We need a Shaolin Monks 2. Okay, I mean, I'm not gonna go and look, but I'll take your word for it. Like, I didn't know that video was like a joke, essentially. They removed the dislikes now, didn't they? They removed dislikes on YouTube, so you don't know anymore. Although I feel like that video was before that. So. We need a Shaolin Monks 2. Yes, we do. Even though I think, I mean, I don't know what NetherRealm are doing next, but like, it's by all accounts, it's going to be MK12, which I'm, for the first time, honestly, since MK9, actually, I don't know, I did actually like Armageddon, but I'm not that excited about MK12. Like, I would much prefer, and to this day, I hope this is right. I really hope their next game is actually MK versus DC2. Or Injustice 3. I don't want them to just do Mortal Kombat again. Because I feel like if it's back-to-back MKs, it'll be, like, it'll just be very, very similar to MK11. And, you know, MK11 didn't really tickle my whistle. Oh, now I don't have a Swordmaster, do I? This is, like, the second half of this game has been a lot more difficult. So, DMC4. Could be interesting. And if I ever get 5 on PC, I'll play 5 as well. I'm also not taunting anywhere near as much as I normally do, because it's, you know, it's just kind of an awkward input. You didn't like 10? No, I loved 10. MKX is sick, man. No, I mean, like, so what I mean by that is, like, MK9, I really look forward to. I was really looking forward to 10, like, so, you know, like, since MK9, like, every MK game, I've been like, oh, shit, yeah, I can't wait to play that. But because of MK11, I'm, like, not that really... I'm not that hot on the idea of an MK12, to be perfectly honest. I'm just like, eh. Like, I don't know. 11 just felt very... Like, it just felt bland, and it didn't have, like... Because here's the thing, like, my complaints with that, like, aren't really gameplay. Like, because, like, a fighting game is very much, like, you know... At a certain level, you're playing the fighting game by the game's rules. Like, for me, it was just the style of the game. It didn't... MK11, like, didn't feel like Mortal Kombat. And not to get political, but they just like to reassure on the I don't know why they did it. It is kind of silly, you know.
Being tweeted and asked what people wanted, MK Shaolin Monks got 60%.
Ugh, if only that was true. What's up, Bergeron?
Do you think NetherRealm could make a good hack and slash?
Absolutely. Absolutely. They did it? I didn't even know it did have it, that. Or a remastered Beautiful Joe? Oh, that'd be sick. That'd be sick, yeah. I feel like they need to take a break from mainline entries for MK. I agree completely. I really do. I think, but I don't think they will. Like, did you guys see how many copies MK11 sold? I'll save you the trouble of looking it up. A fucking lot. Like, you know. Like, Injustice 3 could have been in the works, maybe. And, like, when the figures for MK11 came out, like, the people in charge could have been like, yo, make another Mortal Kombat game instead. Like, we don't care. MK11 sold, like, well over 10 million copies. It's kind of crazy how well it sold. World Needs a God Hand 2. That'd be cool. I still need to play that. Come on, come at me. I knew you'd do that. It's... Yeah, it's one... Yeah, one string and then Helm Spur, yeah. The thing with Ed Boon, though, is that, like... I mean, he probably is aware of it, but... like, when he does tweets like that... Whatever, like, NRS's next game is... Like, whatever their next game is... Like... It's already in development. Like, you know, like, by the time he, like, tweeted that... Like, they're already working on the next game. You know, he already knows what it is. Ed Boon is a master, like, troll on Twitter.
What if they were people aren't the softest? Just do whatever you want.
That depends on where you spend your time, man. Maybe, like, the popular, like, you know, the mainstream, I think, has always been like that. It's just getting progressively worse, you know, every year. Because you still get cool shit. Like, here's a good example. Has anyone seen Reacher? The Amazon series? Like, that is very... Like, that show is very... strange in... You know, by, like, modern media standards in, like, you know, the stuff that's in that show. And yet, you know, they made it. Like, there are examples, it's just... It's just less common than it used to be. And I think that's why more and more, I think people, like, do gravitate towards older stuff because, you know, they're like, oh yeah, you know, it, like, whether it's better or not will always be, like, subjective, but you can't argue the fact that it's different, you know what I mean? Like, if you want to go back and watch Lethal Weapon, you know, like, you will, like, you just won't get, like, a big budget movie like that made in this day and age. So you go back and watch Lethal Weapon, you know. There are people that probably don't like Lethal Weapon, but it's different, at least, you know. It's not like what you're getting now, so. God Hand 2 is the thing I want. Was Injustice 2 any good? Injustice 2 was very good, and Injustice 2 sold super well. Not as well as MK11, but... Like, Injustice 2 sold very, very well. And don't forget, since what? MKX? NRS games have had, you know, like, recurring... like, DLC and... like, you know, stuff you can buy for extra money. That most people... you know, pay for. You know, most people do that shit, so.
Don't play God Hand on a stick. So I'm hopeful it'll come out in the next year or two.
You never know, man. You never know. We're getting... Here's something to give you hope. We're getting a Space Marine 2. We are actually getting a Space Marine 2. So, who knows, man? Who knows? Who knows what sequel might just be around the corner? I still, like, genuinely can't believe we're actually getting a Space Marine 2. I cannot fucking wait to play that game. I just like pray that it's good. Like, I do think it's gonna be pretty hard to fuck that up, but you never know. I feel like there are games where you could say, like, yeah, how are you gonna fuck this up? And then, you know, you get games like Star Wars Battlefront, you're like, oh wow, you guys managed it. Like, you guys managed to fuck up like a fucking slam dunk.
I can't stand Marvel or DC films. Not really a comic fan. I can't wait for the trend to pass.
Yeah, it will eventually. Nothing lasts forever. Remember when? Here's the thing to remember for that, right? From, I would say, what, 2004 to like mid 20 teens, animated movies were just dominating. Like, there were so many animated movies being made because they were just a slam dunk for money. Kids always want to go and see them. Parents are going to go with them. So the people that are making the movie are thinking, oh yeah, if one kid wants to see that, he's got to take both of his parents. That's three movie tickets we sell. That's why everything's made for fucking children these days. Which I don't care. I will still complain about. like, that's why every movie is a fucking 12 or PG-13. Like, And here's the thing on that, and I said this before, like, I don't mean, like not every movie has to have, like, blood and boobs in it for it to be good. I don't mean that, but you're losing, like, the more, you know, like just grown-up drama stuff. I'm watching The Sopranos, the TV show, and you think about it, like, remember when mob movies, like, used to be, like, a big thing, you know? Remember when, like, the next mob movie was like, oh, cool, I'm going to go and see this. Like, it wasn't just because it was, like, violence and had swearing in it. It's because, like, an eight-year-old can watch something like Goodfellas or Casino, but they're not really going to appreciate that film at that age. They'll like it because, ooh, you know, there's swearing in this movie and, you know, there's, like... You know, like, there's like a forbidden fruit kind of element to, like, those movies is why kids will watch them. But you're not going to kind of understand, like, the more character-driven stuff and, like, you know, the moral of those movies. Same with, like, a film like Donnie Brasco, you know? Like, yeah, you could watch that as a kid, but you're not going to get, like, the most out of it as a kid. So, hey, what's up, Zero? I keep hitting the wrong fucking button. Okay, I do have air hike with the Beowulf now as well. You motherfucker. This fight might be like... I don't know. This, I don't know if anyone else was the same. This fight took me the longest on my Dante Must Die playthrough. Like, this took me way longer than any other boss. Like, this fight is just... Like, when the whole fucking chessboard, like, devil triggers, you're just like, oh, great. I feel like the Marvel craze is kind of dying down, though. I don't know if... maybe I'm just kind of disconnected from that, but... I don't feel like... Since the main endgame sequence ended, I can't talk. I feel like they've kind of lost a bit of their, like, momentum, you know?
I can't even handle very hard mode, and this room is a nightmare. People seem to like a lot of Disney Plus Marvel shows.
Yeah, I haven't seen any of them. I don't have Disney Plus, so... Not seen them. I mean, to be fair, like, I don't know, they're probably alright. They seem like another example of like something that you would think on paper is pretty hard to fuck up, right? But I'm sure there are people that don't like them. Look hard enough, you'll find people that don't like everything. It's not too bad on any. I think it's not too bad apart from Dante Must Die. Like on Dante Must Die, like that fight can be a nightmare. Right, I want blue, green. Yeah, so I want. Yeah, you know what? Werewolf's fine for this, yeah. Yeah, it is, yeah. But again, it's like, it's one of those things, like, on when you know how to fight it, it's like, yeah, this is actually quite easy. I wanna. Oh, you bitch. Crap. He's charging, isn't he? No, they're not good. No, I need you to hit me. Shit. But not actually hit me. There, no! Why are you doing that now? Oh, man. Like, just lost, like, all my damage window. No, this is a fresh game, so my Royal Guard's only level 1. Stop hitting him. Admittedly, though, even level 1 Royal Guard is probably easier than trying what I'm trying here, but. I like the noise it makes when you get, like, the ricochet. That is twice in a row that guy has done that. What? Oh, goddamn. He just hit his buddy in the back. Oh, I didn't buy thingy, did I? I didn't buy uppercut with Beowulf. I forgot to put turbo on as well. Look it up my move. Calm down. They do a really good chunk of damage to each other, though. Crap. I never thought I'd actually miss camera control much in this game, but I admit, like, I miss it in, like, this is a fight where, like, I actually do kind of miss, like, having camera control. Generally, like, the camera for this game is pretty, like, pretty good, but, like, when it kind of goes above you like that, it's kind of awkward. Yeah, Royal Guard is better, I just say it's not. My Royal Guard's only level 1. And I just prefer, like, doing the parry stuff. It's just rusty. Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah, you can still block. It's just, like, doing rolls on level 1 is how I like to do that, and like I say, doing rolls on a stick is just not very, like, not very intuitive, so I'd probably just get killed trying to do Royal Guard stuff.
What's favorite people's duo boss? Ooh, that's a good question. Agni and Rudra's up there for me. I really like Agni and Rudra. I'm trying to think of some other dual bosses. Wrong way. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, dual boss. Yeah, Agni and Rudra, definitely. That was my, like, lightning round pick, you know? It was like, boom. Agni and Rudra, for sure. They are hella good. Right then. One. Man, this has taken longer than I thought. We'll go with that. I could try... Nah, you know, I'm not going to. I'm not going to try that. They're the only one I know of. Well, yeah, there's more. It's just... A lot of old school games have double bosses, like side-scrollers. Like, I feel like they were much more common in those kinds of games. You know, you got a lot more dual bosses in them. Hang on. There we go. It can be annoying, don't get me wrong, but, like, the dual clone fight's pretty fucking cool. There's one from Cuphead that I can't remember, but that's a good one. Shit. I really want to play through that again. It's weird, playing through the messenger really made me want to play through Cuphead again. There's a couple of levels, like, in particular that are, like, very, like, Cuphead-esque. Man, that's a lot of damage. Sigma 2? I don't remember Sigma 2 very well, to be honest. Greedy. Getting a bit greedy, but... No, don't do that. It's pretty low here. Oh, shit. Oh, crap. I didn't just... Oh, fuck. I've just turboed my fucking... I did not want to do that. I just turboed my R1. There we go, right. I do not want that. I'll be cancelling my fucking lock-on all the time. Okay, I did not know that had a hitbox on that, but I just learned something.
Ocarina of Time, dual fight.
Agni and... Yeah, say, Agni... I'm having a hard time thinking of one I'd put above Agni and Rudra. It's a really fun boss fight. Is it in Bloody Palace where you get, like, Agni and Rudra, but, like, using both swords as a boss? Right, we want to do servers now. You know what? I'm going to have a quick bathroom break, though. Stretch my legs as well. That's better. No worries, Pork Whisperer. I'll catch you later, man. That is a great username, by the way, if you're still here. Can be interpreted in a weird way, but I like weird usernames. Right, need to... Did I get this? I think I left a green orb. Yeah, I did. I'm sorry, I left a green orb here. There we go. Nice. Yeah. Okay, yeah, it's only 4 o'clock, so... Mission 19, thankfully, is not just fucking cancerous on the regular difficulty. Mission 19, like, you know what? That's one thing about DMC3 I kind of forgot about. Like, is there anyone who has ever said to themselves, yeah, Arkham's my favorite boss in Devil May Cry 3? And whoever, like, if there is, like, that person needs, like, medical help. If anyone, like, watching, like, has never played, like, this game, like, seriously. Like, borrow a save file or something and play Arkham on DMD. Like, oh, God. I think it's the... I'll say this. I think it's the only boss fight in all of DMC that is... Not counting DMC2, obviously. That is just legitimately fucking terrible. It's such a bad boss. Like, it's just so boring. Is it me, or does that do more damage on that one? I should have just Ebony and Ivory cancelled from the very beginning. It's so much easier. You sound mad angry, though, Wolf. What's going on? Talk to me. Another cool thing I like about the lock-on thing in DMC is that you notice, like, that the circle, like, actually depletes with their health bar. I've always liked that. It's like an instant readout of how much health they have. Like, it's not an exact amount, but you're like, okay, this guy's at least half life, or, you know, he's at, you know, under half life. I thought that was cool. It was a nice little touch. What Sunshine are you playing? Because we've only got a couple of missions left, so... Oh, he's on NG2. That's the Ninja No upgrades. Kind of want to watch that, but... We're almost done here, so... Like, first hour... I don't know if I'd, I might trim this down, actually. Because the first hour of this was just me fucking up on mission 12. Which was just kind of annoying. So, I'm thinking of DMC4 next, and, like, what's going to be the thing that I forget about in that game? Because the lack of being able to swap my lock-on here has been, like, the biggest problem by far. Right, now that I've got level 3 Swordmaster, I want Beowulf, please. Dante Styles. Oh, fuck. Yeah, they're all on the D-pad, aren't they? Oh, no. I mean... Oh, man, yeah. Yeah, I had not thought of that. oh, shit, yeah. Because this is my D-pad here. Like you see these switches here? Look, this makes it the D-pad. Now it's the analog stick. So, that's going to be interesting. How much is it to upgrade? Oh, yeah. To be fair, I'm only going to go through on normal, so it shouldn't be too bad. But yeah, I had forgotten about that. The styles. There we go. Now we can play the game. Yes.
I forgot to get, I just realized that I didn't get uppercut, did I? Yeah, I didn't get uppercut with, like the regular uppercut, I mean. You can do that in 5, can't you, if I remember rightly? Even though Meteor looks cool on the lower difficulties, I guess. The thing with Nero will definitely be his charge shot. It would be really weird, like, not being able to, like, just charge that all the time. Right, then. Where is the one I need to hit? Holy water left. No. Oh my God, are you kidding me? The other thing that's annoying in this fight, like, you cannot lock on to the mirror. Which you kind of, like, it'd be really nice if you could. I don't know why I just tried that. Frame rate's fucking dying here, isn't it? There we go. Armor, son. Whoops. I was trying to kill a bee, cancel that. As long as I've got the rocket launcher, this won't be too bad. Exceeding's going to be really awkward, though. Because you think default controls, exceed is going to be this. So it will be, like, with lock-on, it will be like that for exceeds. And that's going to be, like, that's going to take some getting used to for sure. And here's, like, forward back moves and that, like, they're gonna be, actually, I don't know, they might be fine, actually. Alright, here we are. The only legitimately terrible boss in DMC, for my money. It's nowhere near as warm today. I don't know if it was anyone from the UK, but yesterday was boiling. Yeah, it's been pretty mild today. Oops. I'm curious if anyone's watching this on YouTube, If you like Arkham as a boss fight, let me know. I'm sure there's bound to be at least one person. Or is it maybe just the one universal truth, is that this boss is just god-awful. Because this section as well, like, I mean, there are other ways to kill these, but, like, the rocket launcher is, like, the way. Oops, I got hit there. Anyone who likes Arkham is a psychopath. Oh man. He's not the best, is he? To be fair though, if the whole boss was just this, I actually wouldn't mind. The thing that makes this boss really annoying is when Virgil turns up. Because, like, you lose your style, you lose DT, like... Whoops. I'm getting way too greedy with that. I'm gonna let this go just so I can get some health. Arkham, as this boss is boring. I'm not a big fan of Jester, to be honest. Like, don't get me wrong, like, it's nothing on this. Like, but, I mean, you'll notice, like, I didn't fight the second and third Jester fights. Because I just, I'm not a big fan of that boss. I'll do the same, actually, There we go, I knew Virgil was about to show up. I forgot to equip Spiral. Yeah, because like you lose all your Swordmaster moves and like, you know. Fun fact, this is one of those things that like every time I mention it, like there's always someone that's like, "Oh my god, I didn't know that." If you have a second controller here, you can plug in a second controller, and player two can control Virgil. Fun fact. And while I'm on the subject, if you've got Super Dante and you use Doppelganger and you just go in Devil Trigger with a second controller, press start on the second controller will control the Doppelganger. So you can literally play co-op DMC3. That's a pretty good Easter egg. It's like jumping off of Schmorgan's head. You can control what Virgil does here, too. So if you hold forward, like, you'll get Stinger. Like, you can do high time with him and all that. Like, he'll kill a bee if you do, like, you know, jump triangle. Shit. Hey, what's up, Warren? You just Dante only in this fight? Yeah, that'd be fine. Because, like, it is very much, like, story-heavy, but... yeah, like, this is the worst part, because... Like, you can be aggressive, but only to a certain point. Like, if you're too aggressive, like, you'll just get hit. Also, you know what would be another good thing? If this actually did damage to him. Like, if killing these, like, took off a little bit of his health, that wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Like, the homing on them is crazy. Hey, what's up, Archon? I knew about controlling Virgil, but not the Doppelganger. Yeah, say, I feel like it's not a lot of people know that. It's one of those cool things. I remember me and my friend played through that when I beat DMD. Shoutouts to Devil's Lair, that's where I found that out from. You can plug in a second pad and play co-op DMC. And I was like, oh, fuck, like, we have to do this. Like, it's a little bit weird because, you know, you do have to kind of, like, stay within the camera, you know, to keep people, you know, so people can actually do the right moves, but it's really fun. Like, imagine, like, I don't know if it'd actually be optimal, but, like, imagine, like, a Super Dante, like, doppelganger co-op speedrun. There we go. Hey, what's up, Alan? It's going well, man. We're just about wrapping this up, and then I'm going to make dinner. I'm quite hungry. Subuxi. Nice boss bonus. But, yeah, the first part of this was just rough, man, because just, like, mission 12 was just a fucking drag. And, like, getting... Like, it's weird. Like, I got past Beowulf first try, but then, like, fucked it up on Geron. So, like, that added quite a bit of time.
On the PS2 box, it also says one player only.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, exactly. It's one of those things, man. I love stuff like that. Like, genuine Easter eggs, you know? Stuff that people don't act... Like, stuff that not many people actually know. Right, what do we want here? I want that... Yeah, that's fine, actually. I mean... I don't know how well I'm going to be able to kill a bee, cancel Virgil. Because generally with Virgil, like, you want to jump away from him to kill a bee, cancel him. That's pretty hard. That's a pretty awkward input. Bruh. Devil trigger in this early? Surely you can't do that. Never actually tried though. So. You know what? I'm gonna go with my gut on this. I'm gonna go Agni and Rudra. Because I'm not gonna be able to kill a bee cancel like I normally do, so. I'm gonna keep I'm gonna keep the rocket launcher though. What am I doing? There we go. And I'll upgrade my rocket launcher. Even on DMD, like, this is, like, a good chunk of damage on him. There we go. Right, I don't know how long Sunshiny's been streaming for, but... Yeah, because, like, after a stun on him in this, like, you can always get a rocket launcher shot on him. And it does, like, a really nice bit of damage. See, look at that. Bitch. like Helm Splitter into Stingers, like really good for getting him out of DT, but like you really want Devil Trigger Explosion. Man, that is a lot of fucking damage on normal. Oh no, this is on hard actually. Look at that, two rocket shots. Like, look how much damage that was. Probably shouldn't have tried that, but. There we go. The amount of times I've done that and it's constantly fucking me up. There we go. Right in the gentleman's area. There we go. Right, that is DMC3 on a stick. That was way harder than one. Way harder. Cause just you gotta press a lot more buttons to do just basic shit. Right. I do like DMC3's main theme though, it's good shit. Like the main hook in this track is so good. Alright, there we go. It's done. Nero won't be a part of the series now. You know what, I don't know anyone else agree with this. I mentioned this, I think it was a couple of weeks ago actually, but that was one aspect of Devil May Cry 5 that was, I couldn't buy that at all. That's not bad, really. Like, the fact that Virgil would get down and dirty, you know, with a human, like, just no. That makes no fucking sense at all. Like, he cannot stand human beings. Like, I don't know, man. I never bought that in DMC5.